all teachers walk around with, this is what a class should be. And it should have this, and then this, and then this, and then this. And we have to change that. I'm Mary Harding.
Brian Stubbs.
Monique Payan.
I'm the Senior High Choir Director at Brainerd High School in Brainerd, Minnesota.
I teach in the dance program, and I am also the Dance Education Specialist at the Purpich Center for Arts Education.
I'm the Visual Arts Teacher at Adams Spanish Immersion, and I teach kinder through fifth grade.
If the pandemic had not hit,
we would be preparing for our spring concerts.
For this capstone project.
Weaving, printmaking, and we would also be planning for our arts night in May.
Some of the challenges that I think are inherently about having an ensemble of any kind, choir is mine, but band, orchestra, I think is going to be obviously the sense of community. I always talk to my kids about the fact that we're doing music is a big paramount piece of our class. However, being a member of a community is equally as big, or sometimes even bigger. And learning about how we connect with others and how what we do matters is huge. This is achieved by daily working together and daily coming in with all of our disparate thoughts and backgrounds. So that would be the biggest challenge.
I just moved all the furniture in my living room to give myself 8 feet of space. And in my dance studio, 8 feet of space is nothing. Space is hugely important and a big challenge.
During the normal school year, I would see the entire school in 1 week. It just wasn't doable to get together physical materials and pack it and send it home. And I definitely don't have enough markers or color pencils to give to 600 students.
My plan for week one of distance learning is to really concentrate on relationship and connection. So today we had a Zoom meeting, and the joy that the students had seeing each other's faces was pretty incredible.
I have made a little welcome video saying, how you doing? I'm thinking about you and I miss you and I hope things are going well. And why don't you just give me a little sentence about how you're doing?
And all you gotta do is tell me what you're doing to keep yourself from climbing up the walls right now. Just how are you keeping your sanity?
And then I'm gonna be moving them towards actually warming up and practicing, rehearsing.
As you get more and more comfortable with this whole distance classroom stuff that we're doing, maybe we can start doing what we sign up for choir to do, which is sing. I would like to figure out a way to sing.
And then I'm going to start slipping in movement and choreographic skills. And maybe movement either that they can crowdsource from their families or engage in with their families.
One of my first assignments is having students go around at home and try and find things that they could use as art materials, be it scrap paper, junk mail, notebook paper, spices and food coloring for paint, whatever they have to get creative and make art.
Singing especially seems to be very personal. When you start to sing, you're connecting souls, and that's a very intimate business that we do. My kids who like to sing, some of them love to sing, but they would never dream of singing on their own. They love to sing with others. That's why they're in choir. And so again, they're being asked to now sing alone, and now they're going to be worried about what their parents think, what their siblings think. Tomorrow I'll go a little more in depth with it, saying you need to meet with your family and make a decision about where you feel comfortable if you were going to practice singing.
What I'm hearing from students, I'm hearing that they are missing us and they're craving connection. They're missing each other. I'm not going to say us. They're missing each other.
Students that have reached out to me have been asking, are they still going to see something familiar at the end of the year? They want to know, are we still going to have that spring concert? Is the musical really canceled?
My biggest hope?
I guess if I have a hope for my students,
I'm hoping that my students will be a lot more comfortable at home taking creative risks. One of the things I've noticed in my classroom is that it seems that a lot of kids are trying to please me and not really showing truly how creative they are because they're just trying to do well in my eyes. So I'm thinking with them being home and getting to set as much time as they want for art to work, they will be a lot more creative than they would be in the classroom. So
as we are spending more and more time at home, and we're spending more and more time being still, we're reminded that everything, when we talk economy, we talk all these different things, doesn't matter. What matters is our connections to one another. And the arts help us learn how to foster those connections. If there's one thing I hope to do in my kids clicking on regularly, I hope that they get to change gears drastically from all the things that might be thrown at them and figure out or feel a sense of connection again to people who they can't see regularly, but still feel connected to.
My biggest hope is that they really stay connected to who they are and know that what they do is really important and their voice is really important, and that they will be able to know deeply that they are seen and that they matter.
I miss you. I hope all is going well and we'll stay in touch.